Is your Gmail inbox stuffed with unread emails and storage limit warnings? Don't waste your time sorting through it all. In this video, I'm going to show you how to clean up your inbox in just a few minutes. So let's get started. Hello everyone, Scott Friesen here at Simpletivity, helping you to get more done and enjoy less stress. And here within my inbox, I have a little over 1,200 unread emails. These are far too many for me to go through one at a time. On top of that, you'll also see that I am getting warnings about my storage. I've got 97% of my storage used. Now, I could come up here and use my advanced filter, and I could try and delete everything, you know, before a certain date in the past. I could go and sort things or find things by a certain size limit. But not only is that going to take a lot of time, I'm bound to delete something that I actually want to keep. Well, by using a little AI magic, we can do this in a fraction of the time and make sure that we don't delete anything that we would rather keep. To make this happen, we're going to use one of my favorite features within Samebox. Samebox is an email management tool that has so many features to help you keep your inbox clean. But one of my favorites is called Deep Clean. Let me show you how it works, just how simple it is to use, and how quickly it can clean up your inbox. Here within my Samebox account, all I need to do is come down here and select a date in the past. I'm going to ask it to scan for emails older than a particular date, because probably the things in the most recent past are things that you can manage or things that you want to review yourself. But I'm going to click on this date picker and I'm going to go back to maybe midsummer. I'm going to go back to July here, for example. I'm going to pick July 1st, 2024, and then all I need to do is select Start Scan. And what Samebox will do is immediately start scanning all of my emails prior to that particular date. And once Samebox has finished its review, once it has scanned everything within our account, it will send us an email notification. So we can go back, do something else productive, and be sure that we'll get an email notification once the scan is complete. So now that about 2 or 3 minutes have passed, here you can see I've received a new email from Samebox saying, ready to clear out some space in your email account? If I open this up, here you can see exactly how many messages, how many emails it has scanned. There were more than 2,000 different senders with nearly 10,000 emails in total. And it also lets me know how much storage that results in. So these emails equate to a little more than 400 megabytes of storage. I can either click on the View Results button here, or I can simply go back to the page where we started the deep clean, and now we can start to see these details. Now, a few things to note. Number one, it'll tell you when it last scanned and remind us what it scanned for. In my case, emails older than July 1st, 2024. And then it also gives us a note that we can only scan once per hour. I don't know why you would do this more than at best, maybe once a week or once a month, but of course it takes a lot of resources, so you are limited by doing this once per hour. Next up, we can choose to sort this in a few different ways, either by storage used or by total messages. So are you more concerned with saving space? That's what we're looking at here. Everything here is ordered by the total size. Or are you more concerned by sorting it by the total number of messages by that particular sender? Now, just taking a quick glance here at my top 10, it looks like this subscription to this news service, McLean's, is probably number one in both categories, a little more than 1,000 emails and a lot of megabytes here as well, almost 100 megabytes, including all of those messages. We've got a few other ways in which we can sort over here on the right-hand side, but the key thing here is that it is grouping things together by sender, because that's really the most effective way for you to decide, can I safely delete or remove these types of items, or can I keep something. So for example, maybe this thing by Cosmo Time, maybe I do want to go back and review some of those offers or newsletters. I want to keep enjoying content from them. Maybe my Google Calendar notifications. I'm noticing how many many I have kept. Maybe I'm going to change some settings in the future so that I don't receive as many going forward. Now, if you happen to take a look at one of these sender email addresses and say, you know, I'm still not exactly sure what this is all about, you can click on this Show More button, and it's actually going to show you some of the more recent messages, including when the last message was sent. So here you can see I actually haven't received something from GetPocket in some time, but if I want a refresher, these are not clickable, but these are the subject lines. So it can maybe tell me, oh, that's right, I remember what this was all about. So this is really helpful information, a lot easier going through it this way rather than doing it within my Gmail account. So now that we understand what Samebox is showing us, we then have the option to select which of these senders, along with their group of emails, would we like to delete and send to the trash. And the nice thing here is that as you are checking or unchecking, it is keeping a total. So even if I just select the first five, I'm going to remove 3,500 emails. That's a significant size. And it's also showing me how much space I'm saving as well. I could continue to go down through the entire list if I want to. But for our example, I'm just going to select these first five and I'm going to say trash selected. Samebox is then going to give me a quick warning. It's going to move the messages from these five contacts into the trash folder. If I then empty the trash folder, I would get back the storage stated here. Remember, within Gmail, it is a two-step process. First, we have to send it to the trash, and then we have to manually empty the trash ourselves. So I'm going to say I'm sure, and I'm going to say confirm. So it's going to go ahead and move all of those selections to the trash. And again, depending on how many messages that you've selected, this may take a little while, but just like we saw before, Samebox will send us an email. And now that the move has been completed, I've got another email letting me know that everything has been moved to the trash. Once again, it's going to confirm those numbers to me, but the number I'm most excited about is this one, 56. We've taken this down from 1,200 to 56 in just a few minutes. Now, Samebox starts at just $7 a month and comes in both snack, lunch, and dinner sizes. And the best thing is that you can choose which features are most relevant to you. And best of all, you can try it absolutely free. Just go to samebox.com/simpletivity. Not only will you get your 2-week free trial, but you'll also receive a $25 credit towards your Samebox subscription. And yes, you can use the deep clean feature as a part of your free trial. And if you want to learn even more ways to stay organized, I recommend you watch one of these videos next. Thank you so much for watching. And remember, being productive does not need to be difficult. In fact, it's very simple.